Hello everyone, Daud here. This video is about how to register for the PMP exam. We will do a walkthrough of the application process and understand what it takes to submit the PMP exam application successfully. But before we do that, here is a notice and a disclaimer. I have used three different resources in this video. All these resources are from the PMI.org website, which is the Project Management Institute's website. Also, I am not associated with PMI and I do not represent PMI. So now let's look at the application process. The process begins when you start your application. You will have 90 days to fill up the application and submit it. Once you submit your application, PMI will usually take about 5 days to review the application and get back to you. Now, most likely your application will be approved. But in some cases, it may be selected for an audit. In that case, you will be given 90 days to submit the audit materials. Once you complete that, PMI will take about 5 to 7 days to review the material and hopefully approve your application. The day your application is approved, you will have exactly 1 year to register and take the exam. Now, of course, the next step is to submit the fee and then schedule your exam. In case you do not pass the exam on your first try, you will have 2 more tries available. So you can retake the exam 2 more times, in total 3 times within that 1 year. Once you pass the exam, then the certification cycle begins. This is something I will discuss in a separate video. PMP application checklist, which is also available on the PMI.org website, is very helpful in ensuring that we have entered the right information in the right format so that the chances that our application is approved for the first time are very high. Now, what are the things that it recommends? Let's take a look at that. The first is my project entries represent professional project work experience only. I have not included experience such as the following examples, which are not acceptable. And then it gives us 4 examples. My own personal wedding, academic research for a degree granting program, creation of a newsletter, home improvement project. The thing is that the experience that you are going to enter must be formal project management experience in a professional setting. And it's very unlikely that these type of things will be in a professional setting. That is why these type of projects, even if you want to call them projects, are unacceptable. Next, all of the projects I've included are listed individually. I have not listed multiple projects as one entry. Sometimes people will put together several smaller projects and enter as one project. Maybe because they want to save some time and enter just as a one project. But PMI is very specific that if you have done projects separately, just put them as separately. Even if you took on 2 projects at the same time, you have to put on those projects as separate projects. I have included the true title of the project or basic descriptor of the project purpose, not my role on the project in the title field. So obviously, people have been putting in when it says project title, they have been putting in their own title. But PMI is very specific that you need to put the actual title of your project, as well as when you write the purpose, the actual purpose of your project. So do not put in the role description or role name. So for example, CRM implementation project, it's not your title, it's the name of the project. Next, each of my project descriptions are high-level summaries of the project in total. And then it gives us 2 examples. The first one, a brief 1 or 2 sentence project objective. So what is that? The objective of the project was to implement a CRM system to replace multiple legacy systems. Now, it doesn't mean that you have to write in this exactly the same format, but it gives you an idea how to provide the objective of your project. A summary of the final project deliverables, presented end-to-end functionality and received client sign of approval. Now that example also, you don't have to follow exactly as is, but the start and end, which means the summary of the project deliverables as well as the project objective, both have to be brief. Next, my project entries do not include routine, operational or administrative tasks and responsibilities. So things like if you've been checking the grammar of the minutes of meetings or documents, that is not considered as such a project experience. I mean, it is good that you did that, but that will be considered an administrative task. So you do not include that type of stuff. I have accurately indicated the number of team members who participated in this project and the budget for the project. You don't have to have the exact number as is. PMI, the application process, gives you a range. So for example, it says 1 to 4, 5 to 8, or 20 or more. So all you have to make sure is that you are in that range. Now, it also happens that you may have 5 people, and then you had 6 people, then you had 8 people, and then you got back to 5 people. So the ranges will work well in that case. And if you go across 2 ranges, then the best thing is that most of the time, how many people you were managing, that would be the one you enter. If I am selected for the PMI audit process, I am able to obtain proper verification for the project experience listed in my application. So if you are unable to, and you already know that you will not be able to get proper verification, cannot provide the contact person's name for that project, then you should not enter that project. Maybe enter another project. Remember that you will have, when you enter your experience, you can go back only 8 years. So you have to provide the experience of all the project work you did within the last 8 years. You cannot go back further than that. If you have worked on 2 projects simultaneously, then you need to understand how the PMI application process will treat the timings of those 2 projects. Here in this example, we see project 1 and project 2 that ran in parallel between February and April. It does not matter which project information you enter first, 1 or 2. Once you have entered the information, the application will take project 1 to be running from January to April and project 2 to run from May to June. So in total, you will get 6 months for these 2 projects. It means that it does not matter how many projects you are working on at the same time, it is the elapsed time that counts as your experience and not the number of projects. Next, we will look at how to fill the PMP application. For that, you will go to PMI.org website and from the top menu, select certifications. Under that, select Project Management Professional or PMP, and you will reach this page. Go to the section where it says Start Your Application. Now, if you already have an account with PMI.org, then you will log in. Otherwise, you will continue and create your account. The first thing you have to enter for application is your education, both academic as well as professional education. Now, for academic, if you have a bachelor's degree, that is your highest degree, then that's the one you enter. Now, if you have a master's degree, you will have to enter that because you are supposed to enter the highest education you have received. Under professional education, enter the formal project management training that you have received. Now, if you got 35 hours from one training, then you don't have to enter anymore and you can move to the next section. But if your hours from your first training that you entered was less than 35, then you have to enter another training and complete the 35 hours. Next section is experience section. And here you will enter information by projects. So you will enter the title of the project, the organization name, your job title, and then you will do the pull down menu, and from there you will select the functional reporting area. This is like IT, finance, operations, marketing, human resources. Under organization's primary focus, which is the kind of the industry the organization belongs to, so you will select that. For example, energy, IT, healthcare, financial services, so you will select that. Next, you will select the approach or methodology. And you have a choice of selecting waterfall, agile, or hybrid. Then you will select the project team size. Now, the team sizes are given in ranges, 1 to 4 and so on, 20 or more. But in case you have a non-disclosure agreement where you cannot disclose the number of people working on the project, then you will select classified as the choice given there. Next, you will select the project budget. Again, this is range. So 1 to 5 million and so on. And if it is classified, then you select the classified. Then you move to the next section, which is the project description. Now here you will have to enter between 200 to 500 words that is recommended. What is the objective of the project? What was the outcome of the project? What was your role on the project? And what were the responsibilities and deliverables that you worked on? How to enter this information? I'll have a separate video giving you some examples on what type of information you should enter. But we already saw an example earlier that what is expected to be entered in this section. So once you have entered the project information, if one project covers your required time, then you have completed this section. Otherwise, you will have an opportunity to enter more projects. Once you have done this, you move to the next stage, exam details. Here you will enter your home address, your work address, one or the other. Enter the address information, and at the bottom, you will enter what is the name that you want on the certificate. And name that you will have on your identification, which you have to show when you take the exam. Enter the email, phone information, phone number, and where do you want to take the exam. Once you do the check boxes at the bottom saying that you agree to the terms and agreements, and all information that I have posted is accurate and complete, that and then the button that says submit application will appear. And once you press it, your application will be submitted. Now, once your application is approved, you can move to the next step, which is to pay the exam fee, schedule your exam, and start preparing for the exam. Now, if you have any question, please let me know.